Good evening, SSN Canada viewers, and welcome to G. Donald Love Competition Hall. I'm Kaylee Walsh, and I'm here with Ryan Bondi as we get ready to watch the McGill Martlets take on Sherbrooke Vach Eagle. So far this season, the Martlets have won 2 out of 3 games against the Vach Eagle, with Sherbrooke winning the most recent matchup. Last weekend, Université de Montréal swept both of these teams easily in 3 sets. However, Sherbrooke and the Martlets were victorious against the Laval Fougères. Sherbrooke swept the Fougères in 3 sets, while the Martlets pulled off an absolutely stunning comeback victory in 5 sets, which saw a radical lineup changes featuring Montreal native Emily Mathieu-Grasse and Erica Cornoyer. To add more fuel to the fire for this match, both teams only have 2 regular season games remaining and are fighting for a spot in postseason play. Laval, Sherbrooke, and McGill have found themselves in a 3-way tie behind the Carabins. Only the top 3 teams qualify for playoffs. In other words, a victory here will be vital for the Martlets' playoff quest. In order to secure 2 points for the Martlets, what do you think the key points for tonight's game will be, Ryan?
Well, I could be cliche and say the hungriest team will win, because obviously this is a very crucial matchup, as you mentioned, 3 teams tied at 11-6. But I think the key tonight for the Martlets is stopping Roxine Hassani. She leads the RSAQ and kills, probably Sherbrooke's best player, and really kind of their only option. You look at all the statistical categories in the RSAQ, she's atop them all for Sherbrooke. Sherbrooke's not a very good hitting team, and they like to feed her the ball. So if you're McGill, you really got to read her well and try and stop her attack tonight.
All right, let's see how that works out.
And they go right away, right to her, and she hits it out. Sherbrooke's hitting percentage isn't even over 20%. So, as you mentioned, they're not a very good offensive team, but they're second in blocks and second in digs. So they do play a little bit of defense to make up for it. As I mentioned, they're going to go to Hassani early and often. You saw it there with the very first play.
All right, McGill serving. A deep serve, a giveaway point to Sherbrooke.
In our last broadcast, when the Carabins swept McGill, just too many crucial errors, mental mistakes. McGill's not the greatest offensive team themselves. They play great defense, and they're usually a very well-coached team by Rochelle Beliveau, and they're smart. And that was uncharacteristic in the Montreal game, too many mental errors and mistakes. And a service error like that, and Sherbrooke just returned the favor with a service error of their own. So probably a little bit of nerves tonight, too, as this game means so much for the playoff pitcher.
Basket to Roxane Hassani.
Nice dig from MC Lapointe. That's got to get over.
Free ball put over by McGill. Set up. Back to Hassani. She puts it down. Nicely dug up by McGill. A back row roll shot. Nice just put on the line by MC Lapointe.
Yeah, that was a great read from Lapointe there. Saw the open space. Nice little backcourt attack. That's again, Sherbrooke going to Hassani on all 2 opportunities there.
Guuji serving. Deep serve. Libero sets it up. Sherbrooke with the hit. McGill setting it up outside to Amiot. She puts a deep shot, and that one goes just outside.
Yeah, tough break for Amiot. It looked like a good cross court. The spot was there, but just a little long. Amiot, probably one of the best hitters for the Martlets, leads the team in kills.
Chahé Gagné serving for the Verrières. She puts a deep serve in, picked up by the libero. Back set to Amiot. She hits it off the block. Sherbrooke setting it up again. A dump by the setter. Finds the empty court right in the middle of the pool.
Yeah, nice read there from Robitaille.
Chahé Gagné serving. Giving McGill a little bit of difficulty, but nice play to bring it back. Deep push into the corner. Codell sets it up. Outside hit, swipes it off the block. Back to Amiot here. She rolls it. Hassani with a monstrous hit, but that goes way out. The set was nice and high. She had a little bit too much time there. Kat Amiot serving for McGill. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Pushed to the outside. Miguel picks it up nicely. And a nice hit off the block by Ashley Norfleet.
Yeah, that's Norfleet's first kill of the game. Leave off her first set, too. So good start for her, just hammering it hard off the block. She's got a lot of power. She showed us there.
Amiot serving again. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Miguel setting it up. And the point's going to Miguel. There's a back row court violation on the last play by Sherbrooke.
Good start here for the Martlets, up 6-3. Mentioned nerves might have been an issue. Such a crucial game, but Martlets showing none of that. They're kind of a young team too, so they haven't been in this position very much over the last couple of years.
It's that point. Back set to Sani, a little bit outside, but she fixes it a little bit. Norfleet with a back row hit.
Ooh.
Miscommunication there on the Sherbrooke side. Looks like Sherbrooke's trying to regroup a little bit. Yeah, and they're calling a timeout.
Fontaine's going to take a timeout there. That was a weird play. It looked like the setter, Robitaille, was right there to set it up, but then Lambert got it right in the way there.
Sherbrooke actually has two players who can play setter on the court. Kodea, number 11, and 6, Kim Robitaille. So it might have been a little bit of a mix-up.
Yeah, Robitaille was in the backcourt there. So maybe they... A little miscommunication on who's the second ball was for. But yeah, I mentioned a great start here for the Martlets.
Yeah, they took any idea of nerves right out with the start to the game they had. They seem pretty controlled and relaxed and just playing their own game right now.
I feel like the Martlets are kind of a streaky team in that regard. If they're playing well, that gives them so much confidence, and then they just keep rolling. You know, especially in our last week's game against Montreal, just nothing was going well. So then it just kept piling up and piling up, the mistakes, and as I mentioned, nothing really went their way. So it's a good job of them starting off on a good foot and building the momentum from there.
Oh,
nice
great dig
from Gabuji.
Deep shot by MC Lapointe to go out. Looks like Sherbrooke is having a little bit of an injury issue. They made a sub. Kodaf came off. Cassini serving. 7-4 Miguel. And her serve goes out. Nice present for Miguel there.
Cassini with a... Not a great start to the game here. Blasted a couple hits a little long, and then with the service error there.
Hébert serving. Nice serve. Set up. Miguel to the outside. Lapointe into the block, and it swipes off the block and lands outside. Point Miguel.
Hard to tell if that was her intention or not, but something McGill's been good at all season long is those swipe plays.
Just missed the right side of the court there.
Yeah, the Martlets seem to... They've had three misses almost right in that exact same spot, right near the official there, right at the corner.
Lombard serving. Back row set to Norfleet, and she hammers it right into the open court. Beautiful kill by Ashley Norfleet.
2 for 2 for Norfleet, so great start for her. Usually one of the stars for this Martlet team.
Norfleet.
Floated that one a little long. I'm sure she'd like to have that one back.
But all smiles on the McGill side. They all just looked at each other, shake it off. They're ready for the next point. Dubois serving for Sherbrooke. Her serves deep and lands right in the court. Ace.
Just happened to find the line there.
She's going to try and do that again. Amiot picks it up. Set to Lapointe. She hammers it. Nicely dug up by the libero on the Sherbrooke side. Free ball sent over. Back to Lapointe. She roll shots it deep. And a dump, but McGill picks it up. Joust at the net. Sherbrooke keeps the ball alive. Roll shot into the middle, and just unable to play the ball by McGill. Point Sherbrooke.
That was a really good rally there from both teams. Unfortunate for McGill. Looked like they had a couple good opportunities to get the point there, but Sherbrooke never giving up.
Dubois continuing her serves. Oh, and that one dropped right in front of Amiot. That was an excellent serve. There's not much she could have done there. That was textbook serve.
Tough read for Amiot. Just kind of dived right in front of her. Nothing she could really do. Kind of buckled her knees maybe.
Amiot's able to pick this one up. And a kill from Myriam Robitaille.
Yeah, she's getting her first chance at an attack, and she hammers it home. Great for the young player there. Only in her first year. It's going to be a key game for her. High pressure situation. See how she handles it. That's going to be an over bump.
But Sherbrooke able to capitalize it nonetheless. Great read by the setter, Kim Robitaille, to push that one deep.
...11-10 McGill early on in the first set.
David serving for Sherbrooke. That one finds Amiot. Back set to Robitaille. She's blocked at the net. Again, Sherbrooke hits into the block. Basks it to Hassini. Picked up by Northley, but that bump goes out of bounds.
Yeah, decent read from Northley, was in the right spot. Just maybe a little bit too much power on that kill from Sherbrooke. Unable to dig it into play. All tied up at 11 now.
David serving again. She finds Amiot. Amiot going for the hit. And she makes no mistake. She says, you serve at me, I'm going to hit it right back at you.
I think Amiot's going to be a key tonight for the Martlets. Didn't hear much of her in the Montreal game. She didn't get many opportunities. So I think tonight, Coach Beliveau and maybe DeRuji will want to get her going early.
And a serve by Robitaille just trickles over the white tape.
And that's a break they didn't get last week against Montreal. So it's nice to see finally a little bit of luck on the Martlets side.
But this one's too low. Sherbrooke making their substitution. Rosalie Coderre coming back in. And looks like she will be taking on the role as setter.
Yeah, looks like she got her wrist taped up there a little bit.
That serve just whisked off the line and out of bounds.
Both teams kind of struggling with their serve here in the first set. 14-12 Martlets.
Served by DeRuji. Picked up by the libero. Put out, jumps up at the net. And some miscommunication there by McGill. Not quite sure what happened there.
Well, Lapointe had to go for the dig, and then Northfleet kind of backed up because she was getting ready to hit, but then there was no one to get the second ball there because DeRuji was stuck in the backcourt playing defense, so.
Sherbrooke serving. Deep serve, finds Amiot. Outside pass by DeRuji. Setting it up again to the middle. A nice quick play, Abel there for the kill. Well, nicely done.
That was her first attack too. The best hitter in terms of percentage for McGill this season is Hebert. Very efficient. Shows us right there. First attack, first kill.
Free ball over by Sherbrooke. McGill's going to try and set something up. Norfleet with the set. Block, hit into the block. Duwuji sets it outside to MC LaPointe, and she swipes it off the block.
Couple swipes now for LaPointe.
And that will bring us into the technical timeout. 16-13, McGill with the lead.
Yeah, entertaining first set here. Kind of see why there's three teams log jam at 11-6. Kind of some back and forth play.
McGill really taking advantage, thinking before they do the play. They've done a lot of swipes off the block, and that's what's different between tonight and last week.
Yep.
They're just making those smarter plays. Doesn't have to be as hard as you can, just in the right spot.
And we'll see if maybe Ashley Norfleet kind of makes that adjustment too. We've seen LaPointe with a couple of swipes, and Norfleet just, she's been blocked on back-to-back attacks there, so maybe she'll take advantage of that and try and swipe it there.
Sherbrooke is serving quite a bit on Kat Amion, and she's doing an excellent job of picking up those serves. All right, Kat Amion is going to start off her serving. Sherbrooke picks it up, set to power, and a huge hit by Dubois, unable to be picked up by MC LaPointe.
Yeah, nothing LaPointe could really do there. Just kind of had to take it off the chest.
Service coming from Roxanne Hassani. That one's deep and outside. Point McGill.
It's two service errors for her now.
Hebert serving. Dump by Pereira.
Good read from Duwuji.
And back row set to Amion. That one hits into the net. A few nice sets there by Hebert, finding herself in the role to take the second ball. She was able to keep the play alive.
Yeah, I like the idea from the last attack from Duwuji. Trying to get Emmy out in the backcourt. Maybe she should have went cross-court there instead of trying to hammer it down the middle. She had a block. Looked like a double block up the middle.
McGill's substitution. Emily Mack, the grass coming in for Ashley Northley for the serve. She serves it. Sherbert picks it up.
Nice read.
An easy block by McGill. As the crowd is getting into this game now.
Yeah, we got some Sherbrooke fans in the crowd starting a little chant, and then the home crowd didn't like that, so now they're trying to answer back. That was a great read there from Robitaille in the middle there, seeing the quick set right away and making a play.
Play like those that gives teams momentum, and Sherbrooke has to be careful here because with that, McGill can easily start taking more control of this game.
And I think this first set is so crucial, especially for McGill at home. If they can get this first set, kind of get the momentum, carry it on to the second set, could be trouble for the Varior. And we mentioned how crucial this game is all throughout our broadcast because of the three-way logjam there, but both teams kind of have a tough game next. McGill has to go all the way to Laval, always a very tough place to play. Then Sherbrooke has to play the number one team in the RCQ Montreal. So another big stuff from MC LaPointe and Robitaille. Making big plays at the net.
Yeah, there's no way the ball is passing over there. McGill continues serving. Pushed outside to Robitaille. And she tries to go for the line. She misses that. Excellent steering by Emily Matte-Grasse. Substitution for the Verrier.
Yeah, this is something Rochelle Béliveau loves to do. You always see this from her. She brings in her serve specialist late in the set. Usually they're pretty good at defense too. So it's just another piece to help you win that set.
Outside set. Set to Emsla Point. She gets blocked. Miguel cleans it up. Sends a free ball over the net. Put out with the set. One-handed set. Blocked by Robitaille. Outside set. Cross-court
hit. Good dig from St. Marie. Yes, and Robitaille finds the open spot. That's a huge point.
Fantastic play. Robitaille, the set might not have been perfect, but she made sure the ball landed in the court.
Miguel just been dominant since that timeout. Taking every point so far.
Sherbrooke, cross-court hit. Quick set to the middle. Sherbrooke able to pick it up. Back set. All right.
Good rally here. Oof. Tough read from St. Marie. Thought that was going out. Dipped in down the line at first.
Sherbrooke's going to try and get some momentum from that play.
Miguel still in cruise control here this set.
Dubois serving. Free ball sent over by Miguel. Put out with the set. Blocked by Miguel. Sherbrooke setting it up again.
A stud at the net. Getting her hand on it again there. She's going to get a kill opportunity, and she puts it down.
Smart play.
So Robitaille gets her hand on a couple of attacks, and then Dewuji decides to reward her, and she reads it well with a nice little tip.
23-16, LaPointe serving. Deep serve. Sherbrooke picks it up. And a hit into the net by Sherbrooke. Sherbrooke really struggling here to try and get back in the game.
Set point right here, 24-16.
Picked up by Sherbrooke. Set to Robitaille. Miguel able to pick it up, back to the other Robitaille, and she makes no mistake. Miguel takes the first set, 25-16.
I don't think that set could have gone any more perfect for the Martlets there. It was basically mistake-free. Robitaille was big at the net and then had a couple good kills down the stretch. Everyone else was pretty solid. And coming out of that timeout, they just took the momentum. The crowd kind of got into it, and I said earlier in the broadcast that McGill's kind of that streaky team. So if they get on a roll, you know, the girls start playing with more confidence, the crowd gets into it, and everything starts clicking. And that's exactly what we saw as they closed out the first set there.
Yeah, and you can really tell the McGill Martlets are really playing together as a team. Sherbrooke, sometimes it looks like there's a bit of confusion on the court, players are not exactly where they want to be, just they're trying to hammer the ball into the net, and it's not working out for them.
We mentioned Sherbrooke not a very good hitting team, and they like to go to Hassini. So that's something McGill knows, and that's something they're trying to read and playing good defense. We saw Robitaille with great plays at the net, a couple stuffs, and then Sherbrooke with a couple miss hits down the stretch too. So
yeah, and unfortunate for Sherbrooke there. The last 10 or so points of the game, they were stuck in the rotation when Hassini wasn't even on the court.
Yeah.
They couldn't use her for a block. They couldn't use her for a hit. That really hurt them. Not only is tonight an important game for the Martlets to make it to the playoffs, but it's also the last home game for a few regular season home game for a few of their players. We're celebrating senior night tonight.
Mm-hmm. I believe MC LaPointe is a senior. Marie-Pierre Duravage, Virginie Hebert, Daphne Andre Moret, even though she is hurt. She's in her fifth year. And Yasmin Dewuji, I'm unsure if she's going to come back for a final year. She's in her fourth year eligibility. These players have added so much to this McGill program. A bronze medal a few years ago when Nationals were in Hamilton. But they're not ready to end it. And we kind of saw that in the first set there. As Hebert was involved a little bit, and then MC LaPointe did a great job too. And of course, we got to give a shout out to Matt DeGrasse doing a great job serving at the end
of
the first set there.
Coming in as a sub, your goal is to make sure you get that serve over the net, and she did exactly that. Not only that, she made it very difficult for Sherbrooke to handle.
And she's only a first-year player, and it's amazing that Rochelle Beliveau trusts her as that serve specialist. I mentioned that Rochelle loves to do that, put the serve specialist in late in the sets, and to trust a first-year player like that in this situation.
Yeah, it's huge.
Very impressive.
All right, so Sherbrooke's going to start off the service here in the second set. We have David serving. Uji sets it to Amiot. She cuts the ball, and Sherbrooke unable to handle that hit from Amiot.
Yeah, good job from Amiot there going cross court. We had a really good angle on that hit there. She really sliced it down on the opposite side. Gave the Sherbrooke player a bit of trouble.
Dewuji serving, an aggressive serve, pushing it outside. And that's blocked. Nicely picked up by Sherbrooke. Oh, great defense by Dewuji. But this time, Sherbrooke's able to block the ball.
Sherbrooke coach unhappy with the original call that Dewuji actually dug that up. Looked like she got her hand underneath there for a nice little pancake. But nonetheless, Verrier still getting the point.
Charest Gagné serving. St. Marie picks it up. Free ball sent over by McGill. To Hassimi. Oh, huge hit by Hassimi.
Yeah, her best kill of the game so far. Right down the line, straight down. McGill did not have a chance.
Yeah. Sherbrooke with the serve. Picked up by LaPointe. Back to Amiot. And she returns the favor straight down the line. Nobody even moved on the Sherbrooke side.
Nasty kill. It's a great set from Dewuji. Couldn't get her hands on it. But still an excellent pass.
Amiot serving. Over bump by Sherbrooke. But they set it up. Back to Hassani. Sherbrooke, Reed McGill setting it up. Huge block. Great rally here. Free ball being sent over by Sherbrooke.
Still has to use this here. Put it away.
Norfleet with the huge hit, but picked up by Sherbrooke. Back outside and tip play. McGill's able to pick it up. Roll shot by LaPointe. Another roll shot by Sherbrooke. High set to Norfleet. She hammers it. And that goes out of bounds, but it looks like it rolled off the Sherbrooke block. Great break from McGill Martlet.
That was a long rally there. Not a lot of good attacks there, but both teams was able to keep the play alive, doing a great job of keeping the play alive, and then Norfleet finally put it away.
Amiot served this time, but wasn't able to trickle over the white tape. DeLaurier serving for Sherbrooke. Wuji with the set to LaPointe. She roll shots it right down the line. Nobody there. Great vision by LaPointe. Hebert. She puts the serve over. Hobby Dye sets it to LaPointe. And she hammers it through the block. LaPointe on fire here.
Yeah, impressive last couple of points for her.
Hebert. Deep serve. Put out to Hassini. And that does set the next one by Hassini.
Yeah, just a back and forth play there right at the net, and neither team really being that clean, but Sherbrooke still gets the point.
5-4 McGill, Hassini with the serve. Quick set to the middle, nicely dug up by Hassini to the outside for Sherbrooke. They put a deep shot in. Now Norfleet.
Nice little dipping roll shot there.
And that's...
Oh!
Oh, I'm... There's going to be an issue with this call for sure. You see DeWuji going, telling the ref it was out by a foot. I don't know. I agree with her from up here.
Yeah. Crowd not liking it either.
McGill's going to try and shake this one off. Hassini continues to serve. LaPointe with the hit. Picked up. Free ball sent over.
Taking her anger out on that one.
Norfleet. Monstrous hit, and that one's out. But apparently there was a touch on the play. Or touch the antenna. Antenna violation. Emotions flying here.
Yeah, I'm not sure the call on there, but maybe a makeup call.
Miguel trying to take a breath. A little bit of a rotation issue, but they look like they figured it out. Oh, clear foot violation there by Sherbrooke.
Seven, five McGill. They did take the first set. Trying to take a 2-0 lead here.
Norfleet. Nice control serve. But violently tries to pick that one up. Sherbrooke forced to call a timeout here.
Another great start to the second set for the Marlins here.
Yeah. That one play didn't go their way, but they took it, took a breath, regrouped, and got back on track.
Yeah, I've been very impressed with McGill's play so far today. Almost complete night and day from the Montreal game.
Absolutely.
I mean, Montreal is a very talented team, top five in the country. So that could be one of the reasons too, but I think McGill just really hungry for this victory and they need it to get into the playoff. And, you know, anything can happen once you're there. They've beaten Montreal once this season. They've beaten Laval a couple times. So... they've come out hungry here, and they're just playing smart, and they're playing clean. Not a lot of mistakes. A couple service errors, but that's really been it.
Yeah, at this point, it definitely looks like McGill might be the hungrier team. Norfleet with the serve. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Outside set. And that one hammers it, but McGill, once again, able to pick it up. Free ball put over. Back to the outside.
Nice dig from Norfleet.
Bobby Tai turns, puts the hit over. Set to Dubois. She puts it and finds the court. Unable to be picked up by McGill.
That was a nice read on the tip from the Varior there.
Yeah, Sherbrooke starting to play a little bit smarter. They're not always hammering the ball right into the block. Kodav, great serve. Dumped by DeWuji, picked up by Sherbrooke. Set outside to Dubois. Dubois hammers it. but nicely picked up by Amiot. Back to LaPointe. She sends it. That's deep. And Sherbrooke can't pick it up on the second bump. MC LaPointe really making each of her hits count. Great serve by LaPointe. Dubois roll shots it deep. A little basket, a little bit behind Hubby Tie, but she's able to play it. Pushes it to outside. And a great hit by Camille Charette Gagné from Sherbrooke. McGill still leading 9-7. Dubois serving. LaPointe picks it up. Out to Amiot with a tip. Kodak is there to pick it up, but unable to play it. Make a play with it.
Yeah, nice read from Amiot. We saw Dewuji kind of had a nice read a couple of plays ago with her dump, but just didn't drop fast enough. And Amiot with the tip there, and it kind of dropped a little quicker. Sherbrooke unable to make a play on it.
Great serve by Robitaille gives Dubois problems. Dewuji with the nice outside set. No block there for Amiot, and she hammers it right into the back corner.
Amiot's been impressive tonight, just putting some mustard on it.
Hubitaille serving.
And just picking her spots really well as well.
Shahra, she hammers it. And Norfleet unable to pick that one up.
We've seen that a few times now. Norfleet's been in the right spot on defense basically all night, but a little bit unlucky with the amount of velocity the ball is coming at her. But she's right there defensively, just got to maybe stick with it. One of those is going to pop up eventually.
Amiot keeps the ball alive. She's going for that hit. Finds a nice spot. Shahra puts it down the line. McGill picks it up. Roll shot over by Amiot. Quick play in the middle. Oh, and Hassini gets a fingernail on that one. Ooh. Oh, what a play by Sherbrooke to pick it up.
Sherbrooke's foot there, but McGill still.
They were there to defend the hit by Virginia Bell. ...12-8 McGill. Dewuji serving. Dubois really having difficulty on the serve reception, but she hammers it. Huge block, but McGill picks it up. Amiot tries to find the line there, but that one goes a little bit out.
Decent read there from Amiot. Her first set was a little tight to the net, so all she could really do was hammer it off the block. And then the second set, she gave it, Dewuji gave her a little bit more space, and she tried to go down the line, but just a little wide.
Shahai Gagné serving. Dewuji, nice set. Huge hit by Amiot. Fantastic play. Perfect timing on that one.
She's been feeling it. I said earlier in the webcast that we didn't hear her name much last week, and I think Dewuji really needs to go to her, and she has here in this last maybe 5-10 points.
Dubois. Miguel setting it up. LaPointe, cross-court hit. Put out with the dump, but McGill's there to pick it up. Up to Virginie Hébert, but that one goes just outside.
Again, right read, I think. The space was there. She's got to get it down.
DeLaurier serving. Oh, and that one goes into the net.
That's not even close. Can't have those mistakes in it. Crucial game like this one.
Yeah, Sherbrooke coach is not looking too happy on that one.
Chance to get back into it, down 3 points.
Great serve by Beth. Hassini puts the ball up high. Quick set to the middle. McGill picks it up. I mean, Sherbrooke. LaPointe hammers it, and that finds the court.
Everything's working for the Martlets right now.
Smiles everywhere.
Love the aggression, too.
A bath serving. That one's deep and out. Cassini looking for give her team a little bit of momentum with her serves. A little bit of timing issue there by Robitaille on the shoot set from Duji.
I swear that's only the first miss it of the or error of the set so far for the Martlets. They've just been on fire.
Yeah. Another unforced error by the Barrier. Not quite the way they want to bring themselves into the technical timeout.
No, especially when you just got 2 points in a row. You're down three. It's your serve. I mean, you have an opportunity to claw back in it and maybe tie this one up, and then you just serve it long like that. It kind of gives McGill that side out they need, and they can regroup in this timeout and take back control of this set.
You mentioned the aggression McGill has. I think that's absolutely one of the differences. You know, when it's a free ball going over, they don't just look for the easy way out just to bump the ball over. They try and hit it every time they can and really try and get the ball into the court.
So McGill absolutely dominated in the first set after the late timeout. I don't think it was the technical timeout, but I think Sherbrooke took a timeout a little bit later after that, and McGill just dominated since then. So let's see if they can do it again here in the second set.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm sure that's their game plan, too, to keep all their momentum going and basically don't take their foot off the gas pedal. Northfleet serving. Outside to Dubois. She hammers
nice
it.
Nice dig.
Great dig. Now in Robitaille's shoulders were just pointing outside the court there. Made it difficult for it to go in. Pudel serving.
Nice pass.
Set to LaPointe. Out to Charest. I'm not trying to save it there. I'm not.
Yeah, I think she maybe panicked a little bit. I think she could have maybe took another step back or didn't have to throw it as far forward. Just kind of hit it straight up in the air.
Oh, great play by Robitaille to pick that ball up. Great set by Coder to find Charest, who does the cross-court hit.
This time the Varior coming out of the timeout strong.
Yeah.
They're on a roll. Only down one now.
Another serve by Coder. LaPointe hits it deep and off the block, and that gives McGill the point.
MC will serve now.
Great dig. Charest, huge hit, but nicely dug up by LaPointe. Tipped over by Duji, but Sherbrooke picks it up. Ooh, that one could have been called for a double. See the ball spinning there.
Umpires decide not to call it, but set was tight, and the hitter couldn't really do anything with that. 18-15 McGill, second set. They're up 1-0.
Sherbrooke fans cheering for their team. Coder shoots set. McGill easily picks it up. Amiot, cross-court hit. Coder sets it to the outside to Charest. Charest hammers it. A great dig by Saint-Marie. Amiot with a deep tip. Tip to Dubois. Charest is going to try and find the deep spot, but that goes out.
This time the umpire all over that call.
So it looks like Sherbrooke's going to take that late timeout again.
Gill up 19-15 in the driver's seat here. Faith can take a 2-0 lead here. That's going to be huge. At home, get the crowd behind you. And as we've mentioned time and time again, they're just playing mistake-free volleyball. Being really, really successful with their attacks.
Yeah, it seems McGill might have a bit more depth on their team than the Varillon. The Varillon really are relying, as you mentioned, their star player, Roxanne Hassini, but it just seems when they're not in that rotation, when she's in the front, they're having lots of difficulty trying to find some offense. Mm-hmm.
And this is, and you said the exact same thing in the first set, and we're at that stage right now. She's not on the floor. It's late in the game. And that's when McGill went on their run at the end of the first set. They just, I think, had almost six, seven straight points.
Outside set to Charest. She rolls it, but easily picked up by Norfleet. Joust at the net. Sherbrooke picks up another one. Oh, great save by Norfleet. And Kobitai puts that one away.
All-around team effort point there from the Martlets. Robitai making a couple plays at the net. Norfleet with the dig. I think DeWuji got involved a bit there at the net. And that's how the Martlets play. You know, they don't really have a star player. They're not the greatest offensively, but they're smart. They hustle. They play great defense. They keep points alive. Keep plays alive.
Pedal. Back set to Dubois. Nicely picked up by DeWuji. Amiot.
Seeing that defense right there.
Oh. An awkward joust at the net. Easily won by McGill.
And Robitaille is just winning all the battles at the net tonight. Such an impressive first-year player for Rochelle Belleville. Looking like she's going to have a bright future here.
LaPointe serving. Great serve. Set outside to Charest. Picked up by the McGill block. Back to Charest with a tip. Smart play to give Sherbrooke the point.
Finally ending that McGill run.
Dubois serving.
Ooh.
Great serve. Oh, nicely picked up by Saint-Marie. Free ball sent over. Back to Charest, and she wipes it off the block.
Tough serve receive there from LaPointe. I think that one got her off the face there.
Dubois continuing to serve. Way out of bounds.
Not even close. Tough break there for Sherbrooke. McGill only 3 points away from taking a 2-0 lead here. This crucial RSAQ match.
Kobitai serving. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Back to Charest. She tries to cut it, but Abel blocks her.
I mentioned Robitaille's successes at the net. Hubert wants to join the party too.
Sherbrooke making another substitution. Robitaille serves it. Charest with the hit, picked up by Norfleet. Hubert takes the second ball to Amiot. She tries to wipe it, but that one lands just inside the court.
Yeah, right idea there. Sherbrooke able to get in the block down on the floor. Now Asini is back into the game. See if she can rally her team.
David serving. picked up by LaPointe. Ooh, whoa, great play by Dewuji. And Amiok just a bit too much power. Couldn't quite get the flick of the wrist. And the Marlots are going to take a timeout.
Yeah, right idea here from Coach Beliveau. Calm the troops. Only 2 points away from taking that 2-0 lead.
And a timeout at this time in the game puts a little bit of extra pressure on the Sherbrooke player coming
exactly,
into the serve.
The server, yep.
Makes them have to really think about it. You know, a mistake on the serve would be detrimental.
And we've seen a lot of them today so far.
David continuing to serve for Sherbrooke. Oh, great read by Northley to call it out.
We talked about it during that timeout.
Yeah.
The pressure.
That point was by, we could give that point to Rochelle for that one. Set point. Dewuji serving. Picked up by Dubois, joust at the net. Oh, and hammered by Hébert.
Great read from Hébert, getting it done.
And that, McGill now leading the game 2-0. This is huge for the Martlets.
Your prediction looking good so far. You said 3-0 McGill, no?
No, I said 3-1.
3-1, okay.
3-1, but I'll take 3-0.
I thought this would be an intense 5-setter, but you never know. Sherbrooke.
Yeah.
They really need to regroup and take it one set at a time. They win this one and regroup and see how they can battle to win another one. But McGill, everything seems to be going well for them right now.
Yeah. Denis Fontaine, you know, he's a fantastic coach. He always got something up his sleeve. In the past 5 years, they've been playing against the Sherbrooke with him leading their team. You can never count them out until the game's over.
We mentioned pregame, they did beat Laval 3-0 last weekend, so they have the talent and they have the skill to do it. But McGill, I think, is just on fire tonight. Everything's working. Maybe being the smarter team at times, just not making as many mistakes as Sherbrooke.
I think Sherbrooke is similar to McGill in the way that they don't necessarily, yeah, they have their star player, but everyone else, they just need to play together as a team, and then they'll be able to keep up with the Martlets tonight. Sherbrooke has no choice but to come out strong in the third set.
I think if you're Coach Beliveau, you got to be preaching the same thing you have been preaching all game. Is just, let's not take it easy. You got to keep that foot on the gas. Continue what we've been doing. Continue playing smart. Getting the right reads. Stick with the game plan. It's been working so far.
Sherbrooke taking their time here. The last thing that they need is a time violation.
This is a very important set for them. Their season could be on the line here. So it's smart that they're trying to communicate as much as they can.
All right.
Get the job done.
Kobitai with a serve, and that one goes out. 1-0 Sherbrooke. Pada serving. Ava, but Sherbrooke picks it up. Out to Charette. Dewuji, beautiful set outside. Nicely picked up by Dubois. Up to Coderre. She rolls it, and that one just goes over the tape, but McGill picks it up. Amiot with the hit. Huge block by Sherbrooke, but they're able to pick it up. And a dump by Robitaille. McGill tries to do the same, but unable to do it. Big rally there, and picked up by Sherbrooke.
Yeah, a lot of impressive quick reaction there from both squads.
Coderre, float serve. Outside set to Amiot. She puts a little tip, but Coderre is there. And Robitaille, beautiful play to go get the ball. Up to Amiot. Great dig by Dubois. Deep tip by Charette. Dewuji setting it up to Amiot. And she hammers it out of bounds. Sherbrooke taking the lead 3-0. Oh, substitution coming for McGill right away. Marie-Ève Dorion coming for Amiot.
Sherbrooke starting the way they want to here. We've seen it, and every point so far that it's been mistake-free volleyball from them. And it's been paying off. Except right there, an unfortunate.
Yes, unfortunate. Great dig to keep the ball alive.
A couple of players tripped over each other there.
Luigi. Great serve. Outside to Charette. She hammers it outside. Dewuji serving again. Great
nice
serve. Ace. Beautiful. Sherbrooke player couldn't get her shoulders behind that one. The ball just whisked off her arms.
One way to get the momentum back in the set. Nice little service ace.
Coderre, roll shots it deep. Dewuji, quick set to Hébert, but that was read by Sherbrooke. Cassini showing what she can do at the net.
Yeah, it was great timing from Robitaille and Dewuji, but Cassini read it all the way.
Charette with the serve. Great bump by Saint-Marie. Oh, and huge hit by Dorion. Sherbrooke couldn't do anything with that.
Yeah, the sub making a difference right now. Two pretty powerful attacks from her so far. That one leading to a point.
Oh, a nice one. The service ace by Dorion. That one's picked up. Set to Hassini. She puts a tip and easily blocked off the net by the Martlets.
Yeah, just not good timing there from Bavaria or
McGill taking the lead back, 6-4. Dorion serving. Set to Hassini, tight at the net. Picked up by McGill. LaPointe. But Hassini got her hands up. There goes Norfleet, picked up by Sherbrooke. Back to Dubois. She hammers it. Beautiful nice dig. And Miguel unable to pick that one up.
That was a great dig, but Jess forced Awuji to step on the line there as she was trying to keep it alive.
Cassini serving. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Outside set to Dubois. Oh, she tries the cross-court hit, and that one goes squat wide out the outside.
Yeah, rolled off the tape there all the way out.
Hebert. Oh, great set, great play by Sherbrooke.
Yeah, Miguel unable to get a block out there. So that was just easy pickings.
Sherbrooke serving. Oh, a little bit of difficulty for LaPointe. Sherbrooke tying the game up, 7-7. Sherbrooke looks like they're realizing that this set could be telling how their season's going to go so for the rest of the year.
Yeah, it's do or die for them, I think, at this point with Montreal next.
Dubois, oh. LaPointe, outside set to Dubois. She hammers it, but Miguel picks it up. Set to Norfleet. Her hit's blocked. Free roll shot by Norfleet, setting it up Sherbrooke. And a dump right to the middle. Oh, and two players go for it from Miguel, but unable to get it. Great rally here tonight.
Yeah, great hustle all around by both sides. Sherbrooke really bringing their A game in this set, but to me it seems like McGill, they're not as aggressive as they were in the first couple sets. Maybe just trying not to lose it at this point.
Oh, there you see it right there. Set wasn't off, a little touch by Northfield. Sherbrooke able to read it.
Good timeout here from Beliveau. No need to panic at all, but wouldn't mind maybe getting Amiette back in here. She had a very good first two sets. A couple miss hits early on in this set, but she's still been a great player for the Martlets all night. They just need a little bit of a spark. Sherbrooke, give Sherbrooke credit. They've played some great defense this set, so.
Yeah, it looks like they've also switched up their setter combination. Now we have Kobitaille setting instead of Coderre. Looks like it's working out for them. Kobitaille serving for Sherbrooke. LaPointe picks it up, set for Norfleet. She hits it off the block. Set to Coderre.
Good stuff from LaPointe, one-on-one there.
And Norfleet hits it. But the Sherbrooke player hit the net, giving McGill the point.
I think the Sherbrooke player got a piece of it. Anyways, but
Norfleet, ooh, that trickles right over the net. Wow. Sherbrooke almost able to pick that up.
All tied up at nines now. Good job from McGill coming out of this timeout, getting the job done.
Deep serve by Norfleet, that one's out of bounds.
Yeah, a little overcompensation there maybe.
Dubois serving. Her serves have given Miguel a bit of difficulty tonight. Kobitaille, she hits it into the block. Ooh, joust at the net. Awuji back to Kobitaille. She tips it. but picked up by Sherbrooke. Back set to Kodak, and she finds the court. McGill looks like they were looking for a call for the ball to be out, but it looks like it was tipped off the block. Dubois serving again. Wow! Fantastic serve by Dubois. Finds the court right in front of the 3-meter line. She is a serving specialist, that's for sure. McGill fans trying to boost their team a little bit. Deep serve by Dubois. This time it's out of bounds. ...12-10, Varial. Lapointe. Find Charest. Set for Coderre. Into the block, but McGill picks it up. Kobitai, deep shot, and that's out of bounds.
Gotta get that one down there.
Hassani coming back on the front row for Sherbrooke. She looks fired up.
Yeah, Sherbrooke been impressive here in the third set. Mentioned their season's probably on the line right here.
Oh, great pushette. Chara.
Good dig from Lapointe.
Set for Norfleet. Oh, and the huge block. McGill picks it up. Out to Dorian. She hammers it. Picked up again by Sherbrooke. Oh, and she tried to dump it and went straight into the net. Right idea by the setter from Sherbrooke, but straight into the net. Looks like Sherbrooke thinks there was a back row court violation when Northley hit the ball. But the linesman said, no, he saw it. He was watching the whole time. Kobitai serving for McGill. Ooh, and that hits the white tape and not doesn't come over. ...14-11, Sherbrooke with the lead.
Can't have those mistakes when you're trying to get back into it.
Kada. Oh, great airtime by Abel on that one. Hassini hammers it, but picked up by St. Marie and free ball over by McGill.
Gotta keep that one alive.
Chaka hammers it. Oh,
nice
great
dig. From Lapointe.
Great setup here. Sini. Oh, great dig by St. Marie. Annabelle. And
Northfleet.
And Hassini goes in. She hammers it. Great dig.
Lapointe with
the
dig. Great defense here from the Martlets. They're going to be pumped if they win this point.
Hassini. Oh, just too short. Kamuchi tried, but great team effort by McGill. And give it to Sherbrooke for keeping it alive and being aggressive with those hits. Wow, great rally.
Yeah, some great volleyball there.
Kader.
Nice pass.
Up to Hébert. Sherbrooke is able to keep it alive. Free ball sent over. Up to Dorian. Oh, and she gets blocked by Hassini. Oh, and going into the technical timeout. Sherbrooke leading 16-11.
Yeah, they've come out strong in this third set. They've even playing great defense. They seem to be digging everything up the Martlets throwing at them, and they're just coming right back and attacking, putting the Martlets kind of on their heels. Hassini had some powerful kills there. The Martlets did their best to try and play some defense, but Sherbrooke getting the best of them right now in this do-or-die set for them.
Yeah, exactly. If you don't have the best offense, you better have the best defense. And basically just keep on playing until McGill makes a mistake, and that's what's been happening in this set.
So we'll see how the Martlets come out of this technical timeout. They've done a great job in the first two sets of rallying late in the games and closing it out, but they're going to need a comeback this time.
Yeah, you know, you take it 1 point at a time, and anything can happen. Kadaf serving for Sherbrooke. Oh, great serve. Dorion with a nice hammer hit, but that one's outside.
Yeah, it went off the tape there, not off a hand. And now we'll see Emiot back into the game. A move I thought maybe Coach Beliveau could have done a bit sooner. But Dorian was impressive. A couple kills.
Serve right to Emiot there. She gets the set. We'll see what she can do.
The tip.
Trevor tried to sell it with their celebration, but the refs were watching very carefully. Uwuji. Picked up by Dubois. Up to Sini. Oh, great defense. Again to Sini. And she hammers it, but Saint-Marie picks it up.
They're going to feed her often here.
Miguel unable to keep that one alive. Miguel taking another timeout.
It'll be interesting to see what Beliveau says in this timeout. They need to go on a little bit of a... They need to go a little bit on a string of runs here to try and get back into this game. Down 6 points. Sherbrooke just looks in control and they're hungry this set. As I mentioned, it's do or die for them at this point.
Charrette Gagné serving for Sherbrooke. Oh, deep serve picked up by Saint-Marie. Set for Amiot. Oh, blocked! Oh. Sherbrooke unable to control that. Cassini is able to get her hands up, but too much power by Amiot.
There we go. Miguel gets a point out of the timeout. They need to go on a little run here.
Amiot with the serve. Nicely done. Giving Dubois difficulty again. Norfleet rolls it. Up to Dubois. She hammers it. Great.
We're finally getting some production from some different players. Instead of Hassini.
Miguel making a substitution. Matt DeGrasse coming in for Norfleet. Hassini with the serve. Great serve. Over bump by LaPointe. That goes point Sherbrooke. Sherbrooke leading 20-13 in this set. It's almost a different set. Different game. Hassini serving again. Free ball sent over by Miguel. Set to Dubois. She hammers it. Oh, great pickup by Sini. Free ball sent over by Sherbrooke. And LaPointe hammers it. And that one's out. Miguel making another substitution. Erica Cournoyer coming in for Virginie Hébert.
Berrior.
Hassini.
Down two sets.
Oh, great pickup by Dewuji there.
Yeah, good reaction.
Put it out with the set. To Dubois. Oh, she saw the block there and tried to cut it, but that shot's been giving her trouble. A few times she's gone for it, but can't quite get the angle on it. She has the right idea. Cournoyer coming in for the serve. Set for LaPointe. Oh, nice block. Ooh, awkward play there. Miguel takes advantage. Ooh. And oh, yeah.
Nice timing. We can go on a little run here, make it maybe 21-18. This one could get interesting.
Oh, absolutely. Oh. Sherbrooke's, Miguel's setting it up. Now Sherbrooke to Dubois. She hammers it. Oh, the Cobra spike from LaPointe.
Stuff. Matt DeGrasse making a difference at the net with Robitaille here.
Free ball from Sherbrooke to DeGrasse. Oh, great defense. Joust at the net. Oh, one-handed by Robitaille.
Yeah, unfortunate there for the Martlets. They had great hit from Matt DeGrasse, but good dig from Sherbrooke, and then they just made a better play at the net there. Some a little unlucky, though, for the Martlets.
Robitaille serving. Deep serve, and that goes way out. Well called by the Martlets. 22-16. Sherbrooke with the lead. Matt DeGrasse serving for Miguel. Great serve. Up to Coderre. She just puts it in the court. Oh, great dig. Again.
Yes,
back to Robitaille. There you go.
Getting their rhythm back here at the end of the set. We're starting to see some more smiles on the Martlets' faces. Something, you know, looked like they seemed a little stressed as they were down big to the Varior earlier in this set. But now a couple of nice plays, and they're smiling again, having some fun, getting a little bit of momentum.
Yeah, and it's nice to see the subs coming in. You know, they feel, whatever, no pressure, just play volleyball. That's what they're doing, bringing a bit of momentum and energy to Miguel's side.
And even if you lose that this set, you know, you can maybe carry that over into the fourth set and try and come out of here with a 3-1 victory.
Which was predicted earlier. Substitution for Sherbrooke. Number 9, Delaurier, coming on for Coderre. Matt DeGrasse serving for Miguel. Dubois hammers it. And that one was out. Out, sorry.
Make up your mind. Miguel inching closer here, 22-18.
Great serving by DeGrasse, Matt DeGrasse.
Back row hit.
And that one's out.
Would have been a huge point there. Good switch up on the play call from DeWuji, though.
Interesting. Taking off Dubois. 14, Cindy Lambert coming in. But she has an aggressive serve. Up for LaPointe. Oh, great hit by LaPointe. Miguel slowly, point by point, coming closer and closer, closing the gap. Tight set. Outside for Amiot. Nicely picked up by Saint-Marie. Set for Amiot. She hammers it, and that one's out.
Martlets wanted a tip there. Didn't get it.
24-19 for Sherbrooke. Set point. Tight at the net. Sherbrooke picks it up. Quick set to Sini. McGill picks it up. Hobitai. Hosini hammers it and off the block. Sherbrooke takes it. 25-19. Take the set.
Yeah, impressive from them. Do or die, needed it. And they got it. Hosini was very successful in that set, but they also got some production from some other pieces. And I think for the Martlets, they seemed a little bit stressed in that set. Like, they didn't maybe want to win it. And then they got down to the Varior. And then from there, you know, they just got... They didn't have that fun energy that we saw in the first couple of sets. And everything was going well. Everything was going right. They're getting all the breaks in the first couple of sets. They were having fun. They were celebrating. But I think they got to just go back to the roots of why they play this game. Kind of relax a little bit. You know, play smart, play aggressive. And then things will probably work out for them here in the fourth set. Still a long way to go for Sherbrooke to pull this one out. So McGill's still kind of in the driver's seat here, and that's, I'm sure, what Coach Belvo is reminding them.
Yeah, and you know, the set could have ended quite differently. McGill could have given up when they were down earlier, but they stuck with it, closed the gap, and they could take a bit of that momentum, carry them into the fourth set.
Yeah, exactly. They finished strong. They kind of battled back a little bit. So they got to carry that on into the fourth set.
Sherbrooke's going to start off the fourth set with the serve. Set outside to Amiot. And nicely swiped off the block. First point to McGill. Duwuji serving. Oh, and that serve gives the Varior lots of trouble.
There you go. There's a good start for the Martlets. They win this set, and the game is over. Up 2-1.
Another serve from Duwuji, picked up by Sherbrooke. Oh! Monstrous hit by Hosini. Sending McGill a little bit of a message.
No, there's no block on that. I think Hubert kind of mistimed that. Expecting maybe the quick set.
Oh, and McGill retaliates with that quick one. Yeah. Amiot serving for Miguel. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Up to Hassini. Oh, with the tip, but beautifully read by St. Marie. Now Norfleet. Great defense by Sherbrooke. Oh, tight set. And the points to Miguel.
It's the start they needed.
Yeah, those are the type of plays Sherbrooke cannot afford. Amiot continuing to serve. Oh, a short one picked up by Sherbrooke. A little basket to Sini. Picked up by Miguel. And Sini again.
It's out.
Sherbrooke not agreeing with the earlier call.
I mean, Sherbrooke wanted a lift there.
Timeout by Sherbrooke.
Yeah, not happy there with the call.
Yeah, Sherbrooke really can't let that call get in their minds. Otherwise, it's not going to look good for them. But great start by Miguel, up 5-1.
Couldn't be a better start, really. They really just have to keep an eye on Hassini, try and read her. They're going to feed all the balls to her. And then take advantage when she's in rotation in the back.
Oh, great serve by Amiot. Oh, nice play by Miguel. Hassini hammers it. St. Marie was there, just couldn't get the right angle on it.
Yeah, she just has so much power. Trying to will her team back into this one.
Shahai serving. Oh, great pickup. Oh, but Hassini there on the block. Did not let that even pass over the net. Sherbrooke, 1 point at a time here, closing the gap. Charles Gagné continuing to serve. Amiot will send it deep. Oh, out to Dubois. A huge block. Oh!
Kept alive.
Beautiful. A big block by Sherbrooke.
Decent little play call there from the Martlets, but Sherbrooke all over it.
Yeah. They read Northeast like a book. Shahai Gagné serving again. Oh, and that one gives St. Marie trouble. Ace.
Sherbrooke getting right back in this. Four straight points. Martlets desperately need a side out.
Shahai Gagné will continue her serving streak. Oh, and that one goes in the net.
Good break for the Martlets.
Hébert serving. Oh, and Hassini hammers it right in the middle.
Everything clicking for her right now.
Yeah.
Martlets got to see that sooner.
They have a little break now as Hassini goes to the backcourt. Deep serve, and that goes out. Another service error by the Varriere. Coming slightly costly for them. Norfleet. Dubois. She hammers it.
Yeah, tough one on St. Marie there. tight game here in the fourth set.
All tied at 7. Kopitar is serving for Sherbrooke. Buuji outside set to LaPointe. Set for Dubois. Tight at the net. And that one's out. LaPointe with the serve. Great read by Hobitai on the Miguel side.
Yeah, she's just been a stud at the net all night in the first two sets. Really making a difference. So let's see if her play at the net in this fourth set can kind of win Miguel the game.
Oh, nice hit by Kodiakou. Nice pickup by LaPointe. Sherbert finds the court. Dubois will serve for Sherbrooke. Back set. Swiped off the block and out. That one almost didn't look like it passed the net. Miguel with the lead, 10-8. Kobitai serving. Oh, great call by Sherbrooke. That one whistled outside. And now Hussini's back on the court.
Yeah, those floater serves are tough to read sometimes. They are doing a good job there.
Nice try by St. Marie to keep that one alive.
All tied up at 10.
Boucouré serving for Sherbrooke. Oh, and that one's out. Great read by Miguel. Like another service error for Sherbrooke.
Yeah, they're piling up.
Luigi serving for Miguel. Oh, and that one's out.
Both teams just exchanging service errors right now. Maybe feeling the nerves down the stretch. Sure, Miguel doesn't want this to go to the fifth set.
Norfleet. She sends it. There's a touch on that one.
It didn't look like she thought it. She kind of looked a little discouraged after her hit, but.
Amiot serving. Cassini. She tips it, but I don't think it's quite where she wanted to tip it to. Oh, but then she gets up for the block.
They're trying to go quick set to Hebert. Sherbrooke all over it.
Charest Gagné serving for Sherbrooke. Picked up by St. Marie. Norfleet coming in. Oh, and a great hit by her.
Yeah, saw the space down the line.
Sherbrooke arguing that it hit the antenna on that one. Looked like everyone on the court on their side saw it.
Yeah, I don't think Fontaine is happy with the officiating tonight in general. He's been complaining about a lot of calls.
I mean, both sides have gone to the ref for questionable calls. Oh, the Lions judge is coming over to talk to the ref. reffing sometimes such a tough job. Sherbrooke almost laughing. Nevertheless, Point Miguel. Oh, great play by Robitaille. Dumps it right in the pool on the McGill side.
Catching McGill right off guard. No one even close to that one.
Tied up at 13. Cassini back in the backcourt for the serve. They rotated around quickly there. Backs it for Norfleet. She tips it. Sherbrooke picks it up. Outside for Dubois. Dubois goes. She tips it. St. Marie picks it up. Great play by LaPointe.
That was a tough pass for Robitaille to work with.
She had the right idea to do the one-hand set, just her middle couldn't quite get there. Norfleet serves. Great defense by Norfleet. Free ball set over by McGill. Outside head for Dubois. He hammers it.
Yeah, Dubois has really been stepping up here in the last set. She had some nasty kills, and then in this set. All tied up at 14.
Kobitai serving. Up to LaPointe. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Set back to Dubois. She hammers it. Oh, and a kill. Norfleet was there. She just couldn't quite pick it up.
Right down the line. I think this is Sherbrooke's first lead in this set.
Serve for Sherbrooke again. Roll shot. Set outside for Dubois. She'll hammer it deep. Picked up by McGill. Up to LaPointe. Who returns the later. Oh, great pickup.
Huge dig.
Oh, and just a little bit of off timing, but what a dig by the Sherbrooke libero. Joanie Whittam, fantastic volleyball skill to get her hands up.
Impressive. Giving Sherbrooke the momentum going into the technical timeout here. McGill really is going to have to dig deep here. So played so well in the first two sets, looked in command, and then Sherbrooke just came out different animal in that third set, and they're kind of continuing it here in the fourth, so it looks like it could go to five.
Kobitaille will continue serving for Sherbrooke. Oh, great defense by Sherbrooke. Up for Dubois. She hammers it. Quick set. Oh, another dig by the libero from Sherbrooke. Free ball sent over by Sherbrooke.
Gill has to use this here.
Absolutely. Up for LaPointe. Hands up for the block. Up at the net. And put down on that one. Puts it down on the McGill side. McGill calling another timeout just 1 point after the technical timeout. Giving her, Rochelle Belliveau giving her players just a little bit of extra rest.
Yeah, that was a huge kill. So it gave Sherbrooke a lot of momentum there.
Yeah,
maybe just trying to calm the troops.
She had to kill the momentum right then and there. Or at least try to. Sherbrooke, uniting as a group on the sidelines. A little bit more confident now, more together as a team. Pobitai continuing to serve. Great, quick play to the Hobbitai on McGill's side.
I think McGill just needs to get maybe 2-3 points in a row here, kind of get their swagger back, get a little bit of confidence, tie this one back up, and they'll be fine.
Outside for Kodak, picked up by LaPointe. Free ball just trickles over the net. Back for Kodak, and she finds the court.
Yeah, just hammering it off the block there.
Dubois serving for Sherbrooke. Oh, that serve was straight over the net. A little bit of timing issue for the Martlets.
We're going to see some subs here.
Oh, yeah. Erika Cournoyer coming for Hobitai.
That quick middle set is toughest in the game.
When it's on, it is. You can't even defend it.
Yeah.
Then if it's off, it's off. Set for Amiot. She hits it off the block. Oh! Heads up play by Erica Cournoyer there.
The Sherbrooke coaches wanted a double hit there on Cournoyer.
Yeah.
Double touch, sorry.
Yeah, I was expecting the ref to call it myself. Oh.
Gonna hammer that back down. Virginia Bear finds the open space. Only down two now.
Cornway serving again. Oh! Hobbitai called on the carry. The one-hand set.
Still down one. Sorry.
No, it's okay. Oh, went into the net. Sherbrooke getting a free point. And look who comes back on the court. Roxanne Hassini. Fifteen serving for Sherbrooke.
Nice pass.
Set for Amiot. Blocked. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Dumped. Great defense. Amiot with the roll shot and the point.
Great dig from Norfleet starting it all. Maybe that gives the Martlets a little bit of momentum. Just down one now.
Garucci serving for McGill.
Oh. Nice serve. Huge serve. Ties this bad boy up, and here we go.
Game of 5 points. Fans getting into it.
Momentum, just such a different element in sports. McGill seems to have it right now.
Pada. Uji sets it for Norfleet. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Picked up by McGill. Outside for Charette.
She wipes it. Tough break. Good rally from both sides.
Padau serving. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Charette off the block. Oh! And just falls right on top of a Bass head. It's always awkward when that happens.
Yeah, she knew she got a piece of it, was trying to find it, but it was right behind her.
McGill takes a timeout here. Sherbrooke with the lead, 22-20. They take their second timeout of the match, so this is it for McGill for the set.
This game is very much alive, 22-20. Desperately need this next point, then anything can happen. Can't afford to go down three.
Substitution coming from McGill. Emily Matt-DeGrasse coming on for Ashley Northley. So not only is Matt-DeGrasse used as a sub, a service specialist, but also offense specialist. Oh, nice dig by Kodair. Oh, and a roll shot into the net by Sherbrooke.
Yeah, huge break there for McGill. That point was crucial.
Amiot serving for McGill. Tight at the net. Oh, and a net violation by McGill.
That Sherbrooke, one was falling in anyways, so.
Sherbrooke still has that 2-point lead. 23-21. Charret Gagné serving. That deep serve almost out. Lapointe, huge block by Hassini.
Yeah, she's come up big these last two sets.
Set point for Sherbrooke. Charret Gagné. Her serve finds the court. Back set for DeGrasse. Blocks. And the set goes to Sherbrooke, 25-21, and that's, we're going to a fifth set here.
These teams, both 11-6 records, and it's showing right here. We're going toe-to-toe. McGill took the first two. Sherbrooke took the next two, so fifth final set, first to 15. Every point matters. Can't go down early. Sherbrooke really has all the momentum right now. McGill's really going to have to dig deep. They need some senior leadership from Lapointe, from DeWuji.
Hebert.
This is really season on the line for both of these teams right now. As both the teams' next two games are pretty hard. At Laval for McGill. Sherbrooke at home to Montreal. Only three teams of the four get in the playoffs in the RSAQ. It's crazy this. Each side played just completely different volleyball in those four sets. Sherbrooke just, you know, making mistakes, and everything was working for McGill. They had strong offense. Emiot was rolling. Northfleet was rolling. Lapointe was rolling. Robitaille was strong at the net. But then Hassini just kind of took over in the third and fourth set. And even Dubois was making her mark with some massive kills as well.
Yeah, if Miguel could just get a hold on Hissini, then that would solve a lot of their issues. Alright, so remember here that you played a 7 points, and then at that point they switch sides and they continue exactly where they left off. First team to 15 wins.
So Matt DeGrasse sticks in the game for Northfleet.
And Sherbrooke's going to start with the serve. Oh. Net violation by Sherbrooke and a great kill by Emily Matt DeGrasse. Gives Miguel the early lead, 1-0.
Yeah, getting off to a fast start is crucial in the fifth set, only up to 15.
Amiot taking her time for the serve.
Not much time for comebacks.
Set for Codet. Oh, and Amiot's going to pick that up. Free ball over by Miguel. Set outside to Charest. She hammers it. Amiot picks it up. Great play by Hébert. Oh, but unable to get it back over. Service goes back to Sherbrooke. Coder serving. Matt DeGrasse. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Quick to Hissini. Up for... Oh, and a huge block by Robitaille on that point.
That was a tight set, so Lapointe couldn't really do much with it.
Kadav serving. Matt DeGrasse. Oh, and Hissini blocks her again.
Just a beast at the net.
Miguel calling a timeout early in this fifth and final set.
Yeah, Rochelle doesn't want this one to get out of control. They're down 3-1.
Which is not a huge deficit at all.
But it's just they haven't really had momentum since that second set. So everything's going Sherbrooke's way now. This would be an unbelievable comeback in a game that is so crucial. I mean, it's not technically over for Miguel if they do end up losing this one. Laval is playing Montreal as we speak, I believe. So, depending on that outcome, if Miguel can pull a victory out in Laval, then they're also in the playoffs. And Laval is the team on the outside looking in.
Service by Sherbrooke. Back set for DeGrasse. Oh, and she finds the line. Easy bump set spike for Miguel.
Yeah, it's interesting they're feuding Matt DeGrasse here in the deciding set. Comes through there.
Pastini. Oh, wow. Hammers it.
Yeah, Gill had four bodies up. I mean, three up on the block there, but Pastini still powers it straight through, down off the block.
Interesting spin. Update, the Hujie Ah just finished beating the Canadiens.
Wow. So things are very interesting. This game means even more for the Martlets then.
Picked up by Sherbrooke. Tassini.
On the right.
And she hits it off the block. Point Sherbrooke.
Bill desperately needs some momentum here. Big kill.
Deep serve, and that's out. McGill will take it.
Yeah, side out. That was a good way to get back in it. Matt DeGrasse will serve now.
Serving specialist for McGill. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Three ball put over the net.
McGill has to take advantage.
Oh, Hassini's able to get hands up on that. Outside for Dubois. Picked up by McGill. Up for LaPointe. Hammers it. Blocked. Tight at the net.
Tight.
Oh. And McGill's unable to recover. Huge hands at the net by Hassini. Substitution. Northleaf for MC LaPointe. Hassini serving. Finds Northley. Free ball sent over by McGill. Picked up by McGill. Codell. Deep shot, and that goes out of bounds.
Nice read from Emma. I thought that was going in. Good eye.
6-4, Sherbrooke with the lead. Northleaf serving. Oh, and that one just whisks over the net. Outside to Dubois. Hammers in. Huge block by McGill.
Big point. Matt DeGrasse again. Interesting to see how many blocks she has tonight.
You can feel a little bit of a momentum shift over here. Oh, and a service ace by Northleaf.
Well tied up at sixes.
Sherbrooke rallying the troops, coming together. Just telling each other, take a break, take a breath. Northleaf serving again. Up for Dubois, she tips it. Amiot right there. Another tip. Amiot, oh, a tip and game.
Nice, smart play.
And now Sherbrooke takes the timeout.
All of a sudden, McGill roars back. 7-6. Very smart play from Emmett.
Yeah, fifth sets are always back and forth, back and forth. You can have the momentum for 3 points, and then the next thing you know, the other team has momentum.
This one's going to come right down the wire. I'm excited. It's going to be a very good finish. Very entertaining volleyball tonight.
Northley continues to serve. Oh, and out. Back to tied up at 7.
Can't do that in the fifth set. Tough.
Kobitai serving for Sherbrooke. Finds Northley. Kobitai up to Codell. and her hit goes through the block and onto Miguel's side. So now with Sherbrooke leading 8-7, they will switch sides. Both teams trying to regroup as we start the second part of this fifth set.
Having a lot of time to think here on the serve. Crowd's getting into it, trying to will these Martlets into a victory.
All right, Klobitaj serve again. Good serve. Amiot.
Nice
kill. There's a huge hole in that block. Amiot find it. No problem. Tied up at 8. Myriam Klobitaj serving for Miguel. Poder.
Oh, nice play from DeRuji.
Dubois. And she wipes it off the block. Two questionable calls on these sets here. Substitution for Sherbrooke. 14, Cindy Lambert coming in. Oh, her serve goes out of bounds.
Fortunate mistake for McGill, 9-9.
DeRuji serving. Picked up by Sherbrooke. Outside for Charest. Into the block. Back for Charest. Oh, great defensive play. Oh. Tip. Dump. Oh, nicely played by Podel of Sherbrooke.
It's intense.
And Hassini.
Holding my breath on every hit, every play.
Back in the front row.
That's out.
Oh, great call by Miguel.
Couple service errors. There they are. At crucial moments in the game.
Pat Amiot turned to serve. Up for Kodak. Oh!
Stuff. That's out.
Great dig by Klobitaj, but not able to handle it. Miguel taking the lead, 11-10. Amiot serving. Short serve.
Nice serve.
Up for Kodak with the tip. And she gets the point. Tied at 11.
Back and forth, back and forth.
Podaf serving for Sherbrooke.
Nice pass.
Up for Northley. Oh, huge block by Hovitai. Miguel taking his timeout.
It's kind of been Northley's problem all night. She's just been hitting it right into the blocks.
Kim Hovitai for Sherbrooke gets so high on the block.
Yeah.
We can see it right from here. It's quite incredible.
She is pretty tall, so versatile player as a setter. Gill only down one. 12-11.
Absolutely. It is still anybody's game by
especially
far.
The way the set's been going. It's been back and forth. Sherbrooke hasn't been very strong on the serve, a little shaky, so.
Kodav serving. That one goes in. Set for Hébert, picked up by Sherbrooke. Set outside. Miguel picking it up again. Set for Matagas. Up for Hassini. Triple block! And she gets it through the triple block.
She's done that like three straight times now. This must be so powerful. That Miguel block isn't tight enough.
MC LaPointe coming back on for Miguel. Kodak serving again. LaPointe, she hits it out. Oh, and they give a touch. Shocking call by the ref.
That might be a huge call in this game.
To be honest, I did not think there was a touch on it.
I didn't really see it either, but.
Nevertheless, Miguel closes the gap and takes the serve. Dorian serving.
Jeez, that was a tough set. Hassini couldn't really do much with it.
Dorian to serve again.
We're all tied up at 13.
Up.
Nice dig from Emmy at the ball's alive.
Free ball over. Nice dig
again.
By Amiot. Huge block. Free ball over.
Sherbrooke putting all
dunk.
The pressure on. But McGill's.
And that's out.
Set point. Sherbrooke. Sherbrooke was all offense on that point, though. McGill's kind of on their heels, trying to just keep it alive every time.
Camille Charest-Gagné serving for Sherbrooke.
A lot of pressure. She gets it in.
Set for Christy LaPointe. Who hammers it, and it goes out.
And Sherbrooke does it, down 2-0.
Oh, my God. Wow, what a game.
Intense, 15-13 in the fifth set. Couldn't get any closer than that.
The Martlets absolutely stunned.
Looked like they had that one up 2-0. Really dominated both those opening sets.
And they even were strong in the fifth set too. Wow, what a game.
I think we're going to have our senior ceremony right now, so it's going to be a bitter one for these Martlet players as McGill now moves to 11-7 and Sherbrooke to 12-6.
And as I mentioned earlier,
Laval now at 12-6 as well. So McGill still alive. They have to go to Laval and beat Laval. So that's always a tough place to play.
Definitely not an impossible task for these relentless McGill Martlets. definitely doable for them.
Yeah, they've beaten Laval before. So, again, an impressive victory for the Varior, being down 2-0. Great comeback.
Varior had lots of fans in the crowd tonight. Definitely must have helped them. Smiles everywhere for this team.